Good afternoon, guys, and welcome to MYP. My name is Roscoe, and if you are new to the broadcast, welcome. Here at MYP, guys, we focus on six key dimensions of your life. We have health and fitness, career, wealth, self-actualization, family and community relationships, and your psychological well-being. Those six areas are very, very important to me and very, very important to the people I work with. And every day we send out you a little bit of advice to help you get through the day and maybe just brighten up, have a bigger impact on yourself and the people around you. So today we're focusing on psychological well-being, so basically how not to get stressed at Christmas. And this is really important to myself, as Christmases in the past have been very stressful due to work relationships and due to things that are going on in my life. But the one big key thing I want to talk about today, guys, is being nice and kind to yourself. So I'm going to give you four bits of advice about how to be kind to yourself and how that will impact other people around you positively. Let's go. Okay, so one of the common themes I have whenever I speak to any of our clients at MYP is usually based around a pain point that I have with a partner or a friend or somebody they're closely related to. And it usually goes along the lines of, I want to do more of this for myself to make something better. So they usually fill that gap with, I want to do something better for myself to make my business better, to make myself healthier, to make my wealth situation better, any of the six MYP dimensions. They usually start having the conversation with their partner or that person who's close to them to say, I want to do this for myself and then this will be better. But what happens is the partner or the person listening, all they hear is that I want to do something for myself. And it's really hard because actually you need to be a little bit selfish sometimes for yourself and look out for yourself to be a better service to the people around you. So I've been speaking to, I think, three or four different clients in the last 24 hours, and they all have the same thing. I want to do this for my business, but in order to do that, I'm gonna have to pull away from work. And I was talking to a guy yesterday, and he sort of runs he's a musician, he does a lot of stuff with music, and he works from home, but because he's at home, he then gets drawn into doing stuff at home with a young baby and other family members and all this other stuff going on. And I know what that's like. And I've recently just moved from working at home to working in a shared working space. And I said, what you need to do is you need to explain to your partner that actually having time to be more productive for yourself will allow you to be a better service when you are at home or when you are present. So I suggested to him about actually moving to this space that I'm recording now here from and working in this space, because I said you could go there and be more effective for 3 or 4 hours here working and then go home and not have to worry about anything to do with work, and you'll be a better service at home, okay? So you'll be present, you won't be thinking about emails and texts and work stuff. You can be fully in the moment. So I'm gonna give you now four bits of advice about how looking after yourself can help you benefit yourself to begin with, and then the people around you. Number one, make time for yourself. So whether you're an early morning person or a late night person, make time for yourself, okay? Now, a really good trick is to make time for your partner first, and then make time for yourself after. So if you want to take time out to train, if you want to take time out to go reading, to do something for yourself, create some time for your partner or the person that you're trying to work with to have some time for their self. So whether it's look after the kids so they can go off and have a manicure, or look after the kids so they can go away and go shopping. Do something for your partner and then ask for that time back, okay? So that's the first time. Number two, compassion for yourself, okay? So be understanding about what you're about, okay? You'd be happy to show compassion for other people, but give yourself a little bit of compassion. So have a bit more understanding about all the good things and the bad things that have gone on in the past, but be compassionate, directed at yourself. Number three, treat yourself. Now this kind of links in with number one. If you're gonna treat yourself, make sure you treat the people around you as well, okay? Because if they just see it as a selfish act all the time, they're not gonna appreciate any benefits. But if you can treat yourself, take the time to treat your partner, treat the person that's working close with you in that relationship. But be seen to be doing it for both yourself and the other person. You treat yourself, you'll be in a happier place, you'll be in a far better space to be interactive and to be present and to be mindful of those moments that you share with your partners, whether it's with kids, family, especially at the stressful time of Christmas. Treat yourself, treat the people close to you, and everyone will be happy. It doesn't have to be monetary based, it doesn't have to be anything to do with value, it may just be time spent together, it may be small little notes or little ideas that let your partner know that you're thinking about themselves, about them, and those little times for yourself, they'll be really beneficial as well, because you'll actually understand that I've been good, I've been successful, I want to treat myself, I want more of the good stuff, and you'll be more positive and productive moving forward. Number four, this one's really important, look after yourself, okay? I've talked about this in the past, and it's the whole oxygen mask coming down in an airplane, okay? When the air hostess does a little talk, they say in the event of emergency, the air oxygen mask will pop down from the ceiling. Put yours on first before you can help anybody else, okay? And the reason is, if you don't put your oxygen mask on first and you start to panic about the child or panic about your friends or your family first, you then start to get sort of worked up and you actually start to consume more oxygen. You may then pass out, which means you'll be of no use to anybody. So put yours on first and then help them. It's the same in life, guys. You've got to look after yourself first. So whether that means doing exercise, whether that means making time for yourself, whether that means creating situations where you can be productive in a work environment to then be of better service when you come back to those relationships, okay? So really do look after yourself, okay? So very important, look after yourself first. It may be perceived as being selfish to begin with, but look at the long-term effect. If I'm a little bit selfish for 20 minutes a day, I'll be better when I'm working with you. So for me, myself, it's I need to get out of the house, do my work, and then when I'm at home, phone's off, email's off, and I'm present, I'm with the kids, and I'm with my wife, okay? You need to look after yourself first to then be a better service when you come back. Guys, there's your four tips. We are on the countdown and the slide into Christmas. We're going live tonight, 7:45 on the MYP Facebook channel. We'll be talking about how to plan for 2017. So the how to plan and the why to plan. I'll be sharing my stuff with you, and hopefully you guys will get involved too. See you tonight, live at 7:45 on the MYP page. Laters, guys.